your mind. Hey everyone! So today I'm going to be teaching you how to make a crochet cupcake container. Ta-da! I got this idea from Goodnick's blog by Lisa Gutierrez. So if you want to see the original tutorial, I'll put links in the description below. But otherwise, you can follow along with my video. And it's slightly different because I added a few little tweaks of my own. So let's get started. Okay, so the first thing you'll need is an empty butter or sour cream container or anything like it, and it can be any size. You'll then need some scissors, tapestry needle, a G or H hook, and then your choice of color for your cake and frosting of your cupcake, and also for your cherry if you want. Then you'll also need some placeholders. To start, grab the color yarn you want for your cake and slip knot it onto your hook. And then what you're going to do is you're going to make a chain as long as your container is tall. Also, make sure to leave a 6-inch tail at the end of your slip knot, and you'll be using that later. So your chain, when you measure it up next to your container, should come to about there, right to the bottom of the lip where the lid will clip on. And then once you've gotten that height, then you want to chain one more, and that will just be to start your next row. So then start in the second chain from the hook and just single crochet on down to the end of your first row. So when you get to the end, chain one and then turn. And then for your second row and then onward, we're going to crochet in the back loop only. So single crochet into the back loop. Basically, if you look at your stitch, it should be shaped like a V. And you will insert your hook into the middle of the V and single crochet around the loop that is furthest from you. So when you get to the end, chain one and turn. And then you're basically just going to repeat that pattern until your piece is long enough to wrap around your empty container. So the reason why we're crocheting in the back loop is that it creates a rich pattern that looks very much like the bottom of a cupcake. If you want it to look more flat,
you can just crochet into both loops as normal. From time to time, you may want to double check that your rectangular work is still fitting properly on the container, that it's not too tall and overlapping where the lid clips on. Okay, so once you've got it to the proper length, you're going to whip stitch it together to form a loop. So don't break off the yarn you were working with just yet. What you're going to do is you're going to use that 6-inch tail that you left at the bottom of your slip knot when you started. So thread it into the tapestry needle. And then you're just going to slip your needle in and out of the stitches on the ends. And you'll want to do this as evenly as possible. Don't panic if it's a little off. You can also use a placeholder or a pin if you have trouble holding it in place. Get to the edge, just go once through again, and pull through into a nice little knot. Not bad. So then, you're just going to thread the tail into your work somewhere so that it just keeps it from coming undone. And it looks nicer. I'll be clipping that tail off later. So now, take the yarn that you were working with earlier, chain one, and then you're going to work around the edge of the cake there. And the number of rows that you did should be the number of stitches that you end up with. But if you don't know how many rows you had, don't panic. I didn't know either. So just try to make it as evenly as possible. And the way I did it was I crocheted in a part where the ridge popped out and then crocheted over where the ridge indented. And then I just kept going with that. So when you get to the end of the row, just slip stitch into the first chain one that you made. And for the second row, we're going to slip stitch into the back loop in each stitch around. And this is just going to form a nice little lip that will wrap around the curved edge of the bottom of the container. So once again, when you get to the end, just slip stitch into the first slip stitch that you started with at the beginning of this row. And it might be a little tricky because when you slip stitch, it tends to be kind of tight. So just show it who's boss. If for whatever reason you still can't get it in there, it's okay to just slip stitch into the back loop. Then just break off and pull your yarn through and then clip off any ends that you've put through. I flipped my piece inside out because it just looked better. So it's really up to you. And then I took the end there, and then again pulled it through the piece to make sure that it's not going to come out and that it just looks nicer, and then snip off the end. And there you have it. That's the bottom of the cupcake. Okay, so here's where the real fun starts. Slip knot your frosting color onto your hook, and then chain three, and then slip stitch that together to form a ring. Then you're going to chain one, and then do six single crochet into the center of the ring you just formed. So now what we're going to do from here is instead of slip stitching to the end of each row, we're just going to continue on a continuous spiral. So here's where you're going to want to have placeholders. And if you don't have any and you don't want to get any from the store, you can just use loop-backed earrings or a safety pin. Now you'll notice that I didn't use any because I like to crochet dangerously, but I would really recommend marking your place, especially if you tend to have a lot of distractions at home or just don't like counting in your head. So the next thing you're going to do is mark your place and then do 2 single crochet in each stitch. And that should give you a total of 12 stitches. Okay, so for the next row, we're going to start crocheting into the back loop from now on. So mark your spot, then crochet, single crochet into the first stitch, then 2 single crochet in the next stitch, and repeat that 5 more times. So you should have a total of 18 stitches. So for the next row, you're going to mark your spot, then single crochet in the first stitch, single crochet in the second stitch, and then in the third stitch, you're going to do 2 single crochet, and then repeat that 5 more times. So 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet, then 2 single crochet, repeat. So that should give you a total of 24 stitches for this row. So then you're basically just going to keep on increasing until you reach the size that you need for your lid. And it's kind of like doing multiplication tables for each row, like say row 5, you're increasing in multiples of 5 times 6 because that's the number that you started with in your first row. So 5 times 6 means that you would have a total of 30 stitches for your 5th row. And then, you know, for the 6th row, 6 times 6, 36. So it seems slightly complicated, but once you get the hang of it, it's not so bad. I will put a description in the box below this video for maybe up to about 10 or 11 rows. You probably won't need more than that. When you've increased enough, then for your next row, you're just gonna single crochet in each stitch around. Now I increased up to 9 rows, so I had 9 times 6, which is 54 stitches, so I did 54 stitches around. Your number may be completely different. you've single crocheted all the way around, double check with your lid to make sure that it still fits right. It's better to have it be on the smaller side rather than the larger side, because you can always add more later if you need to. And you'll see that I do. And then slip stitch into the next stitch, break off, and pull your yarn through. And now we're gonna work on the shelled pattern of the frosting. And this is completely optional, you don't have to do it, but it makes the cupcake look a lot nicer. So slip knot a new thread onto your hook, and then we're going to use the back loops, rather the front loops that you didn't use when you were crocheting around earlier, and then slip stitch your yarn into that to connect it to the frosting. And then chain one, and then you're going to skip two loops or stitches, one, two, and then do five double crochet into the next loop slash stitch thing. Finish the five double crochet, you're going to skip two more loops and then slip stitch into the third one. And then you're going to start that process all over again. So skip two loops, five double crochet into the next loop. And then once you're done with that, you're going to skip two more loops, and then slip stitch into the next loop, and then repeat, 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 until you get to the end of the frosting. the very bottom row, you're going to continue on in the same pattern, but you're going to work into the front loop of the row, the bottom row. So as soon as my hand moves into the picture, there we go, you can see where I'm crocheting at. So here I'm going to skip two. And then right there, I will crochet into the front loop, like so. And I forgot that I was supposed to slip stitch there. Whoops. So try that again. And then just continue on. The very end, just slip stitch into the very last stitch that you can. And before breaking that off, measure this on your lid to see if you need to add more. And you probably will have to, especially if you want to make your frosting stand up a bit from your cake. I had actually broke off, so you can skip this step, but if you've broken off yourself as well, just start a new thread and slip stitch anywhere in there and just begin again. So what you're going to do is then chain one. And then because you worked into the front loop in your last row, you're now going to single crochet into the back loop in each stitch around.
Thank you.
you get to the end, just slip stitch into the first chain at the beginning of the row. And see here, it gives it a nice little lip that will be hot gluing onto the lid later. But it's not very tall. And we're going to be stuffing it, and you don't want to overstuff it because that'll warp the lid. So you'll want to add at least two more rows, well, two rows to the bottom of it. If you want your frosting to be very tall, you could do up to about four off the bottom. I only did two. And that worked very well for me. So again, I chained one and then just single crocheted into the back loop in each stitch around. When you get to the end, just slip stitch into the chain one, and if it's as tall as you want it, then go ahead and break off. And that concludes the frosting. Okay, so for the cherry, you're going to take the color that you like, slip knot it onto your hook, chain three, and then slip stitch that together to form a ring. The cherry is completely optional, so if you want to skip this step, you can. So for the next row, you're going to chain one, and then do six single crochet into the middle of the ring you just formed. So it's basically the same as how you started the frosting. So if you need to use placeholders, you should. And you also may notice that my hook is different. My yarn for the cherry happened to be a little bit thinner, so I had to use a smaller hook, but you'll probably be using the same weight of yarn that you have for your frosting and your cake. So if you need to increase less than I do, feel free to skip the third row. And I'll talk about that in a minute. So for the second row, mark your spot, and then you're just going to do two single crochet in each stitch around for a total of 12 stitches. So like if you have larger yarn or you just don't want a large cherry, you can stop increasing at 12 stitches. So for the third row, you're going to mark your spot, then single crochet in the first stitch, then two single crochet in the next stitch, and then repeat that 5 more times for a total of 18 stitches. Now, if you don't want to increase any more than 12 stitches, just skip this step. Now, for the next 3 rows, you're just going to single crochet in each stitch around. So, if you increase to 18, then single crochet in 18 stitches around for 3 rows, and if you stopped at 12, just single crochet for 12 stitches around for 3 rows. And this is just going to give your cherry some height. So now, once you've done that, you're going to decrease to make it a spear. So if you're at 18, then you're going to mark your spot, then single crochet in the first stitch, then over the next 2 stitches you're going to single crochet. So insert your hook, yarn over, insert your hook in the next stitch, yarn over, and then pull through all 3 loops on the hook. So again, single crochet, and then to decrease, insert your hook, yarn over, insert your hook again, yarn over, and then pull through all 3 loops in the hook. And do that until you've decreased until 12 stitches. If you started with 12 stitches to decrease, then skip this step. Now I flipped my cherry inside out here just so that it was easier to work with. And you may want to do that, or you may not. So if you're decreasing from 12 stitches, mark your spot, and then you're going to decrease over 2 stitches, and then repeat that 5 more times. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over, and pull through all 3 stitches on the hook. And do that 5 more times. Just repeat that until you end up with 6 stitches around. Once you're done with that, you should have something that looks like this, and then you're going to slip stitch into the next stitch, pull your yarn through to make a knot, and then break off, but leave about a 6-inch tail, because we're going to use that to attach the cherry to the cupcake. Now to stuff the cherry, I just used a little bit of the red yarn. And I did that by wrapping it around my finger into a little ball, and then I clipped that, and then just shoved it right into the cherry. And this kind of works better than stuffing because you won't see any white through the holes of the crochet. It'll just be the color of the yarn inside. And it's a very tiny thing, so you're not using a lot of yarn. So now that it's nice and poofy, we're ready to go. So take your tapestry needle and grab that tail off the bottom of the cherry and thread it through. And we're basically just going to be attaching it to the very tip top of the frosting here, where your first ring loop hole is. So just kind of slip your needle under some loops and pull through. And then slip your needle back into the next stitch on your cherry. And then pull that through. And then just keep repeating all the way around until it's nice and snug to the top of the frosting. So you're basically just whip stitching the cherry onto the top of the frosting like you did with the cake. When you get to the end, just whip stitch it in there one more time for another loop so that you can form a knot to tie it off. And then you're going to thread your yarn up through the cherry and then back if you like to make sure that it's good and secure. And then go ahead and snip it off. So now we're just going to pull in the ends of all the loose ends of the frosting so that it looks nice and crisp. And you just do that by threading it through in the piece somewhere and then clipping it off. I had quite a few ends here. And if you have any that are loose, just give them a nice little knot and tug there before you thread them through. To glue it to the container. And for that, you're going to need your container handy, your cake bottom, your frosting top, and a glue gun. So to start, get your cake wrapped around your bottom, and then I put the lid on there to make sure that I wasn't going to glue over where it clipped on. So just hot glue around as close to the bottom of the lid as you can. Be careful not to glue onto the lid, because then you'll glue the lid to the container. If you do happen to do that, which I did, just pull it off right away. But just keep going around in like 2-inch sections. And then stick the cake onto there and hold it in place for a couple of seconds to make sure it's good and firm. So once you've attached the top, then you can start hot gluing around the bottom lip of the cake. And I found this part kind of tricky because of the weird curve of the container. So just be patient and make sure that you're getting it where the cake actually touches the container. Once you've attached everything, then just go around and double check that there aren't any gaps anywhere, and then just make sure it's completely hot glued all the way around. once you're done with that, you can start on the lid. So first, just hot glue like an inch and a half on one side, and then attach your frosting to it and hold it there for about 5 or more seconds. And then you're going to want to hot glue the opposite to make sure that you get it on there evenly. Same thing, about an inch and a half strip, and then hold your frosting on there for like about 5 seconds. And then you're just going to hot glue around one half of it, leaving the other half open, because we're going to stuff it in a second. And you want to make sure that the yarn isn't overlapping the edge of the lid too much. Now for the stuffing, you can use like polyfill for dolls and such, but I used fake snow. And if you get this stuff, you know, in the after Christmas sale, it can be pretty cheap. And it works just as well. So stuff your frosting so that it poofs up a bit, but not too much, because you don't want the lid to bulge on the bottom. And then just hot glue the rest of it on there. Now it's going to be a little tight to hot glue it after it's been stuffed, so kind of smash it down so as you're hot gluing it so that it doesn't stretch the yarn and leave gaps. So again, make sure all the gaps are filled. And then peel off all the little glue stringies. And then give it a good fluffing so that it's not lopsided. And then press it firmly onto your container to make sure it fits. You should hear a click. And there you go. Nom 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 nom.